FCIF, Farmers Insurance Group.
San Jose, California, the site of the Central Coast Section Softball Championships. Two have been decided. The Division II Championship up next, and it features teams that posted upsets to get here. Mount Pleasant, the home team, seeded seventh, and will take on the Gilroy Mustangs, seeded eighth. And Gilroy, a big upset win over Mitty, which we'll get to. Alongside Tim Fitzgerald, I'm Kirsten Fairchild. Thank you so much for joining us on PlayOnSports.com, your destination for high school sports. Gilroy entered this tournament with a 15-12 record, yet they faced off against Mitty 25-0 in a quarterfinal game. Nine innings it took. Gilroy came through with a 6-3 victory. And that set them on their winning ways. They then took care of fifth-seeded Los Altos in the semifinals by a score of 2-1 to earn their spot in the bracket.
Yeah, this should be an exciting matchup. No clear-cut favorite. Both of these teams were underdogs coming into this tournament, sort of middle-of-the-pack teams that came out of it. So no upper dog to be had today. And I'm curious how this is going to play out. We've definitely got some talent on both these teams, even if they're the Division II, maybe not quite as heralded. It should be some good ball today for sure.
Well, and Mount Pleasant out of San Jose, the number 7 seed, started this tournament at 19-5. They took care of second-seeded Lee 10-7 in the quarters and then beat Hillsdale 2-1. Hillsdale was the number 3 seed. And Tim, what was interesting about that semifinal win is that Mount Pleasant scored both of their runs in the first inning. Hillsdale had two base runners thrown out at home before scoring in the sixth, but it wasn't enough, as it'll be number 8 Gilroy taking on number 7 Mount Pleasant. Gilroy with a chance to make this a Southern section, if you will, Southern CCS section sweep. Notre Dame of Salinas winning the D3 title in five innings by a score of 14-1. Then San Benito comes back in five innings by a score of 10-0. And Gilroy turned out the big blue is here in force for Gilroy.
Yeah, you mentioned the way that these teams got here. A little bit more emphasis for these two on their strong starting pitchers. They have carried them, each of them, the workhorse starters, versus some of the other games we saw today with big offenses. It's all about the mound today, the two workhorses that carried these teams.
That's right. Mount Pleasant, coached by Manuel Resendez. And Mount Pleasant will turn to their pitcher, Celine Alcantara, who is the emotional leader of this team as well, and their fortunes have rested her on all season. They don't have another pitcher.
She is it. She is their bread and butter. She carries them, and I'm excited to see her and her curveball. Big curveball, apparently her toughest, her strongest pitch, and strength is locating it, spotting her pitches.
And for Gilroy, the starting pitcher is Lauren Castro, and Castro, a sophomore, she is the stud, she is the workhorse, and she also was on varsity as a freshman, and with an injury to their starting pitcher last year, she got some valuable experience at a young age.
Sure did. Tilt her grow and be the star this season. Also their number 3 hitter. She is the all-around force for this Gilroy team.
So Gilroy, coached by Julie Bergeron, all in her fourth year. She's also the athletic director. Gilroy last won a CCS title in 1999. Mount Pleasant not only has never won one, they've never even made it to this title game. It'll be number 7 Mount Pleasant taking on number 8 Gilroy. We'll have the first pitch when we return. You are watching PlayOnSports.com's coverage of the 2013 Central Coast Section Softball Championships. Powell Stadium Police Activities League. Here in San Jose, the site of the 2013 Central Coast Section Division II Championship. Number 8-seeded Gilroy Mustangs taking on the number 7-seeded Mount Pleasant Cardinals. Mount Pleasant located in San Jose. I'm Kirsten Fairchild alongside Tim Fitzgerald. We'll have our first look at Gilroy. What a season. They have struggled, yet here they are in the championship game. And leading things off for Gilroy will be Kaylana Marl. Before we get to that, let's set the Mount Pleasant defense. In left field is Leilani Lane. And our center fielder we will get to in just a moment, Megan Gracer, the right fielder. And still looking for Mount Pleasant center fielder. That would be Lily Resendez. And starting at third base today is JoJo Castro. I also have Emily Randall at shortstop. Laura Jacquez is second base. Mona Yanez at first. Rounding out the battery is Ernestina Carrillo behind the plate. And in the circle, Celine Alcantara. As stepping in for Gilroy is the shortstop, Kaylana Ma. And the corner's in against the leadoff hitter. And just like that, strike one.
Celine, the only pitcher the Cardinals can go to in this one. They will need her to be strong today. As a windup, she kind of comes off to the side and then really winds and fires.
Fools her with the off-speed pitch to get ahead in the count. Another off-speed, but out of the zone for ball one. 1-2. High school softball plays 7 innings. There is a 10-run mercy rule after 5 as Ma gets things going for Gilroy with the leadoff single.
Right through the gap between short and third. One of these Gilroy players will be playing at the next level.
Celeste Mendoza, the third baseman, steps in. She has been batting over 500 on the season, and she's got a base runner with no outs here in the top of the first.
Today's starting third baseman.
And we've talked a little bit about this curveball. We've seen a lot of heat today. We've seen a lot of movement, but for Mount Pleasant, our starting pitcher, their only pitcher, relies heavily on the curveball. Foul tip for 1-1.
Crowd,
one strike.
Yeah, crowd filing in here.
Yeah, a little late coming. Well, we had started a minute early, and a great grab, a third chance for the double play. Nope.
Oh.
But terrific reaction by the third baseman for the first out.
What a great stab at the hard liner coming right at her.
That was JoJo Castro making the play. Lauren Castro, the pitcher, steps in. One down, base runner on, and Castro. So coming home, excuse me, making the turn was the base runner. So just like that, 3 up, 3 down. Some great defense behind the pitcher for Mount Pleasant.
The coach's niece, Lily Resendez, with a great running catch out in center and doubles up.
I didn't think she was going to make it.
No.
I didn't think she was going to get there. Great speed. And Mount Pleasant off to a terrific start in their first ever CCS appearance. And setting the defense for Gilroy. Holly Lamb in left field. Nicole Green, the center fielder. Rachel Tomlinson over in right. Celeste Mendoza, the third baseman. Kaylana Ma. At short, Kristen Simpson, second base. And over at first is Anna Gamboa and her sister Amber Gamboa behind the plate, the catcher, and Lauren Castro steps into the circle for Gilroy. Leading off for Mount Pleasant will be the third baseman, JoJo Castro. Center fielder Lily Resendez. will hit second, followed by the shortstop, Emily Randall. Ernestina Carrillo is the cleanup hitter, the catcher, followed by Celine Alcantara. Laura Jaquez, Mona Yanez will be hitting seven, Lalani Lane eight, and Megan Gracer rounds out the order for Mount Pleasant.
Number nine, third baseman Jolene Castro.
Fresh off her fantastic play at third on the hot shot, Castro leading it off.
So Castro losing her glove out of the back pocket. Guess that didn't want it on her hand. Bottom of the first, seven-seeded Mount Pleasant up at bat as the first pitch inside for ball one.
Castro brings both arms up over her head before delivering and winds one up big.
Castro the batter and Castro the pitcher for this matchup.
Yeah.
Fouled back for 1-1 as Mount Pleasant arriving, the red to our left of Mount Pleasant. The blue of the Gilroy Mustangs on the right. A lot of excitement surrounding this D2 championship. The 1-1 delivery outside for 2-1.
A lot of moving parts by Lauren as she gets going. But according to her coaching staff, she is the stud of this team.
Gilroy has such nice size. And
sure do.
Castro in the circle, a sophomore. Count 3-1 to the leadoff hitter, JoJo Castro. And this one fouled out of play.
Big, tall foul ball came in on her hands that time. Fought it off.
Our D1 game, the seeding held up. It was 1-2 with 1 winning the championship. San Benito Hay Balers. This one is truly up for grabs as in the dirt. For a full count.
We had 2-4 in our first game. And that was 7-8
matchup. Of everything.
Yeah.
We just missing the 5-6. Need another division. So a full count payoff pitch coming from Castro to Castro. In the dirt or low, but swung on. So a big strike three. As JoJo Castro heads to the dugout, Lily Resendez, the left-handed hitter, to step in.
Lily made the great catch in center.
Center fielder, Liliana Resendez.
Double up a runner back in the first, in the top of this first. The niece of the head coach, Manuel.
As the corner's in, looking at the slap hitter, called strike one.
Manuel, a former third baseman himself, a baseball star in his time.
A lot of fun asking coaches where they matriculated at as ground ball. It's foul. And Manuel, both of our head coaches today actually in their second time around.
Yeah,
very
a second stint.
Interesting.
With,
yep. Both of them needed a break or took a break, regardless of the fact. And we'll get to that as this game goes on. One down. 0-1, and Gilroy fans wanted a call. 1-1. Gilroy youth baseball game taking place here at Powell. Getting all the Gilroy residents interested, and now a little more protestation from the Gilroy crowd. I don't think they're in the know here that we have a uniformed San Jose policeman that handles any unruly behavior. 2-1, make that 3-1.
Makes you wonder if they did know about the previous game's bigger strike zone. Got a little bit more.
Different.
Yeah, coming back in a bit this one.
Different umpire.
Yep.
second consecutive strikeouts, but they haven't been easy for Castro. She's been extended in the count as Randall steps in. She's hitting 460 on the season, the shortstop. Two down at bottom of the first, 0-0 the score.
Yeah, got her to chase there. Resendez chase one out of the zone, tailing away.
Low for ball one.
The Emily Randall backers get into it there.
I like it. Cries of let's go, Emily. She's ahead in the count, 2-0. Solid contact made. It looks to be a base hit. And it is for Emily Randall. So a two-out single for Randall gets a Cardinal aboard as the cleanup hitter, the catcher, Ernestina Carrillo, steps in.
The catcher, number three, Ernestina Carrillo.
Carrillo headed to San Jose City College.
What a program San Jose City has in softball. Just great junior college program. As ball one, and perhaps catching the runner. Ooh. Nope.
Randall took a big lead off of first there. Gamboa put the throw down to second just in case. Yep. Get her to return.
Two out, bottom of the first. These two teams meeting for the first time this season.
It's been a theme all day.
And check swing for Carrillo fouls it off. 1-1. A big moment for Mount Pleasant High School. First ever appearance in a CCS championship. And the student body has turned out to support this team as a big cut for strike two gives the Gilroy fans something to cheer about.
Yeah, this student body is amped for sure, both sides.
Mount Pleasant appearing on Play on Sports for football a number of times. Very hospitable to us, not located too far away.
Yeah.
And another big cut. So despite giving up a single, it's three strikeouts for Castro in Gilroy after one inning played. We have no score.
She really buckled down after giving up that liner. Got into some full counts, but knew how to put these hitters away.
Gilroy, again, upsetting Mitty. Mitty 25-0 coming into this tournament. They'd beaten Gilroy about a month before by a score of 6-0, but Gilroy putting up 16 hits against Mitty. And Mitty's head coach in the bleachers, not in the dugout for that game. He had been ejected from the West Catholic Athletic League Championships. But nevertheless, Mitty unable to contend with Gilroy, which took advantage of that second opportunity. Gilroy beating Mitty 6-3 in nine innings. And that first run, breaking that 3-3 tie in the ninth inning, my understanding was that a runner was coming around second and there was interference called on the shortstop, so an extra base was given. But then Gilroy going ahead to put up two more outs. As Mount Pleasant's defense out on the field, Gilroy sending their cleanup hitter, Amber Gamboa.
Catcher number 23.
Gamboa, the older sister of the first baseman, Anna Gamboa. Second inning underway. Strike one. And Amber Gamboa doesn't hide her displeasure.
Especially after being behind the plate last inning. Wondering where that was for her.
reaching down low. And it's Resenda once again making the play in center field.
Handled the high sun well, read it, got under it, made a nice catch, two-handed.
Holly Lamb, the left fielder, steps in, one down. Top of the second, 0-0 in the Central Coast Section Division II championship game. Swings at a low pitch, foul tip.
Lamb up there hacking is the junior.
Fouls it off. Julie Bergeron, the head coach of Gilroy, also the athletic director. She played her high school softball at Del Campo near Sacramento. This is her fourth year of this go-around, as it's a strikeout for our pitcher first of the afternoon for Alcantara.
Yes. Razor set up on the outside part of the plate. Got it right where she wanted. Just grazing the front corner.
As Anna Gamboa steps in and fouls off the first pitch. Gilroy able to get their leadoff hitter on, but then mistake, miscue, and base running.
Yeah, she thought that one was going to drop too. Didn't think Resendez would get to it.
Yeah, so perhaps not a mistake, because Resendez made a great play. And this hit high and gloved by the third baseman. Three up, three down for Mount Pleasant. After one and a half, the score is 0-0.
Quick work by Alcantara that time. Got a K, got a couple of pop flies as well.
Celine Alcantara has carried the load for this Mount Pleasant squad. Again, the only pitcher. And Mount Pleasant co-champs of their league with Willow Glen.
Wilson, the official softball of the CCS. Thanks to Wilson.
Yeah, Alcantara has to shoulder the load, and she's done a good job of carrying it so far.
Mm-hmm. We're talking to Mount Pleasant's head coach, Manuel Resendez, asked, you know, what was the turning point for their team this season? He said it was actually a loss to Evergreen Valley, a bitter defeat. They had called a team meeting. The girls were so disappointed. Allowed them to refocus and look at where they ended up here in the championship game for the first time in the history of the school.
It's often said you learn more from the losses than the victories, and they certainly did by getting on a run to get here.
The pitcher Alcantara steps in.
Leading off the bottom of the second for the Cardinals, batting fifth. Pitcher number
on deck is Laura Jaquez, the second baseman. Alcantara, that sounded like solid contact and nearly up against the wall at the warning track. Alcantara giving the Gilroy fans something to worry about, but a great play in center field by Nicole Green.
She gave that one a ride. Green did a good job of turning, looking for it, kept her eye on the ball, and pretty much right at the track, made a great two-handed catch.
One down for Laura Jaquez. Facing Castro for the first time, looks at ball one. Mike Patterson behind the plate today, our umpire down at the first base. On the bases, Craig Bryson, and over at third, Tyrone Murphy. And this time finds the outside corner, this pitch for one and one. Right down the gut for strike number two.
Both these pitchers keeping on the black on the edges of the plate, doing a great job of getting these called strikes.
Outside corner for strike three, fourth strikeout of the afternoon. This one a punch out as Mona Yanez The first baseman steps in, two down, bottom of the second.
Hitting seventh, number 10, first baseman Mona Lisa Yanez.
So Lauren Castro certainly fitting the bill of her coach's description.
And she's got it dialed in at the moment. I get the short names from the head coach, Mona Yanez, and then I hear from Andre Polizzi, the PA announcer, is Mona Lisa Yanez.
They want us to be familiar terms.
And a comebacker to Castro, taking her time. Three up, three down. After two innings of play, 0-0 the score as I turn over the call to Tim Fitzgerald.
Thank you very much, Kirsten. I want to remind everyone that we are on Facebook and Twitter. You can follow Play On Sports on Facebook and Twitter to get news and information and links to great highlights. Follow us on Play On Sports on both Facebook and Twitter. You can also access thousands of live and on-demand games on YouTube at youtube.com/playonnetwork. Keep up with all the high school action every week from your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Yes, we'd like to thank everyone for joining us here on playonsports.com. It's been a fun afternoon here in San Jose, and, you know, there were some legacies that were added to with Notre Dame Salinas winning their 13th CCS title, San Benito winning its eighth straight. The record is 9, and here are two teams. Gilroy, it's been a drought since the 1990s. Mount Pleasant, never. So
some fresh blood here in this one.
There you go. Fresh blood indeed.
A couple of teams hungry for that first taste of a championship as Alcantara has her sign and delivers. Bit outside for ball one. Still scoreless here in this third. The 7th seed versus the 8th for the Division II CSS championship. Hot shot foul, inside pitch that she pulled.
The oohs and ahs.
That was quite the rip by the center fielder Nicole Green, who made a great play in center in the bottom of the second. There's a ground and a short, and the out.
That one hit hard, but handled well.
Emily Randall on the one hopper.
Randall, who has had the only hit thus far, mm-hmm. showing she plays defense as well.
She sure does. Quite the all-around player for these Cardinals. So Kristen Simpson checks in. And a foul dealing. She comes right out throwing strikes, does the big sophomore.
Hitting ninth, number 2, right fielder Megan Grazer.
A couple of times now she gets it to 2 strikes and then gets the Cardinal hitters to chase out of the zone.
There's been a lot of chasing going on by this Mount Pleasant squad thus far.
So Megan Grazer up and strike one.
I feel like the PA announcer should warn these crowds about the muscle.
Yeah.
That is here.
And here's a liner into right, just foul by a foot.
One of the few pitches we've seen going the other way.
Yeah, very true.
One of the first contact hits we've seen going the other way. That would have been trouble if it would have dropped in.
Sure would have. She was probably looking at 3 bases there. So she steps back in the box, does Grazer, down 0-2. Castro winds and fires. In there for strike 3. Got her looking.
She's really getting the call on the outside corner.
Yep, she keeps going right back to it.
Top of the order, third base.
So we come back around to JoJo Castro.
First strikeout victim of the day for Castro, who now has 6.
Swing and a miss. Going back outside again. Owen won the count. No score here in this third inning. Here's a liner into left. It will get down in fair territory. It's bobbled, and she will head into second, Will Castro. Throws backed up well at first. was Holly Lamb out there in left with a nice cutoff. That will be a double.
Two out double by the leadoff hitter, JoJo Castro.
So our first runner in scoring position today. Two outs here in the third.
Yeah, just the second base runner for Mount Pleasant. Seen a lot of two out hitting here today.
Getting that outside corner as the zone begins to expand a little bit these past couple
Lauren
innings.
Lauren Castro looks surprised that that was called for a strike. She'll take it.
So that brings up Lily Resendez, who's had a busy day, a good game so far out in the field. And she slaps one the other way to third. And the side is retired. A nice play at third by Celeste Mendoza. And that will end this third inning, still scoreless.
For Mount Pleasant, the bottom of the third, no runs, one hit, no Gilroy error.
Mount Pleasant in action yesterday at Gilroy High School for the CCS Track and Field Championships. Mount Pleasant actually has a wonderful history as far as some track athletes go. And Julie Bregman, the AD at Gilroy, we made sure our PlayOnSports.com crew to thank her for her hospitality yesterday. Such a smooth running affair. Certainly appreciate all they do at Gilroy High School for hosting event that perhaps, you know, that and swimming, I'm not sure there are more athletes from different schools with parents, coaches, et cetera. Those are the big events, swimming and track and field. But nice, healthy crowds here all day. Capacity crowds for all three CCS championships.
Yeah, this crowd was a little more late arriving, but it has filled out.
It kind of trickled in. Maybe traffic is impacted.
Had to wait for the previous game to clear. So Kaylana Ma up to bat, back up to the top of this order. Swing and a liner into left, just foul. Came out first pitch hacking. Really drilled that one into left.
Sure did. Gilroy, 1 through 5 in particular, very aggressive hitting. Is expected to play at the collegiate level at Simpson University in
sure
the fall.
Sure is. This one in the dirt. Count is even at one apiece. Pitcher's duel so far here in this top of the fourth. Swing and a foul. Strike two. The 1-2 pitch. Low and in. Missed with that curveball that time. She does have quite the breaker, Kirsten.
Awesome. Just out of the zone, but a beauty nonetheless.
Setting up away. Here's a grounder to third. It's handled. And the throw gets her. Nice play that time by the third baseman, number 9.
Great infield
JoJo
defense
Castro,
by
yeah.
Mount Pleasant today. You know, we heard so much about their pitcher.
Third baseman.
Yet really backed up by the defense here early on. The Gilroy hitting these balls very hard, and this Mount Pleasant defender is able to handle that.
Yeah, Alcantara gets him out in front with that breaking ball and induces a lot of grounders. Strike one. This might be our loudest, most emphatic crowd of the day.
You know, you don't hear uniform chanting at softball games a lot, except from the dugouts. So I think Gilroy, which is certainly well known for just being a very supportive and cheer-friendly, they're kind of looking over there thinking, maybe we need to start organizing. They're more intermittent
chatter. Yeah, they are.
This is a lot of fun. Great atmosphere here.
Team chants versus individual ones on the Gilroy side. This one called on the outside part of the plate. This zone has certainly expanded since the second. So a 1-2 count with one out, still scoreless here in this top of the fourth. Swing and a miss, struck her out. Two down.
Looked like Mendoza made up her mind she was going to swing at that pitch no matter what. And that's the second strikeout for Alcantara.
That's going to bring up the number three hitter. Lauren Castro doing it all for these Gilroy Mustangs. She looks at a ball low.
Castro perhaps robbed of the nice play in center field back in the first.
Yeah, Resendez chasing that one into the right center gap near the Golden Harvest sign. This one a bit inside, 2-0.
Pitcher versus pitcher.
In this at bat and in this game, they're the story so far.
They are.
Here's a grounder to third. Another nice play by Castro. Oh, but the throw goes high. And it will be an error. She gathered it well, just maybe one too many hops, thought about it too much.
Well, I think JoJo Castro was going to release that ball earlier, but she had to throw over her pitcher. Mm. And I think her pitcher ducking, she took another step, got a little off her rhythm. But, yes, the error allows Lauren Castro. And I believe we'll have a courtesy runner. Maybe not.
No change.
Castro.
Catcher Amber Gamboa.
So Gamboa comes up. Those are the little things. Even if you're not directly involved in the play, that you got to do to help your fielders out. Got to duck down. Get out of the way of that throw. This pitch is lined in the center. Left center. Back goes. Oh, and it's over the head of Resendez. One run will score. It's a double for Castro. Pardon me. That is Amber Gamboa, the catcher.
So the unearned run comes across. Resendez, again, got a great beat on that one, but just too difficult of a catch.
We'll have our courtesy runner now, Adriana Ortega, for the catcher Gamboa. So a 1-0 Gilroy lead here in this fourth with two outs.
Another two-out rally, if you will, by a team.
Extended innings can be the downfall of a team.
Courtesy runner at second base for Gilroy, number 5, Adriana Ortega. Now batting left fielder, Holly Lamb.
So number 10, Holly Lamb at the plate, the junior.
And our head coach for Gilroy coming out too.
Having a little chat with the ump.
And I think we're going to have our umpire come on over and talk to the Mount Pleasant dugout. Our police officer listening in as well.
Just in case he needs that information. Doing his investigation here.
In our previous game, certainly some fervent chatter from one of the team's parents or fans. Nothing profane or unpleasant, but they
some
sure
hard heckling,
quieted
yeah.
Hard heckling quieted up when a uniformed San Jose police officer came over and asked them to keep
swing and a miss.
Sportsmanship
very true
at a premium.
Yeah, the can't argue balls and strikes, wherever you are. Can't go too far with that.
And this is the Police Activities League Stadium.
Here's a fly ball into left. Back goes Lane. And she makes the catch. Whew, two hands, but it was a bit of a challenge for her. So the unearned run comes across the plate. That could be a big difference. What is a pitcher's duel so far? Gilroy up 1-0 as we head to the bottom of the fourth.
Yeah, that's tough for Alcantara. Had those two outs.
Yeah, got the ground balls like she's been doing all game. That one couldn't be handled. And JoJo Castro had been doing such a great job over there. Fielded it cleanly, but just an errant throw.
Still plenty of softball left to play, however.
Very true. Lauren Castro has been tough to get anything off of. Some random base runners here or there, but that's been it.
Both of these coaches are in their second stint at the school. For Mount Pleasant head coach Manuel Resendez, he was a coach for 13 years, took a five-year break, and is back now in his first season and able to bring his Mount Pleasant team here to this championship game for the first time.
So Lauren Castro back to the mound, back to the circle, a bit inside on the first pitch. Ball one.
Sun beginning to move here.
Yeah.
Tough for the left side of the field.
Yeah, creating some shadows as Emily Randall comes up to the plate. She swings and drives one in the left, and it will be caught. Oh, what a play by Holly Lamb out in left, sliding down to both knees and making a two-handed catch.
You know, this game is just going underway, and perhaps because the first two were so decisive, I already feel like the defensive plays that we've seen in this one, whether it's in the infield or the outfield, have really been noteworthy.
They absolutely have. This has been the more defensively crisp games we've seen, minus the one error that led to a run. So here comes Carrillo. Ernestina fouls back the second pitch. The count is even at one apiece. Yeah, I would say the outfield play especially. Very high quality. And the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Came back inside that time. Here we are, two strikes again, though. We'd expect to see them set up away. They do. Just outside. Boy, Gamboa was expecting that call. She popped up. So a 2-2 count. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck her out for out number two.
Seventh strikeout for Lauren Castro.
Mowing him down. That'll bring our pitcher of the Cardinals to the plate. Alcantara.
Yeah, she had that deep ball to center. Deep fly ball to center back in the second.
Mm-hmm.
Really testing the length.
Swing and a miss. Chased a high riser.
Yep.
Like she was gunning for the fences on that one. The pitch. Fouled back. That one looked like it was possibly outside, maybe nipping the outside part of the plate. She went after it.
Lauren Castro does such a great job getting these batters to chase.
Working both sides of the plate, up and down, hitting her spots. Here's a grounder to second. She's up with it and makes the play. And nicely done by the second baseman, Kristen Simpson. So down go the Cardinals in order. 1-0 Gilroy as we head to the fifth.
The conclusion of this game, we will name our Central Coast Section softball player, the Play on Sports.com player of the game at the conclusion of this game during our Play on Sports.com post-game show. Plenty of softball left to play, but make sure you stay with us for the Play on Sports.com post-game show. Gilroy High head coach Julie Berggren. In her fourth year, she had done four before, took time off, came back, now in her fourth year.
Second four-year stint for her.
Mm-hmm. He's got a lot of multi-sport athletes.
Sure does.
Montoya Valdez, an outfielder, plays golf. Nicole Green plays volleyball. Holly Lamb plays basketball. Katrina Carter plays field hockey and soccer. Adriana Fagoni plays volleyball.
We saw Holly Lamb show off that athletic ability and left last inning.
We sure saw, yes.
Here's the first pitch. Popped up into left. Lane is under it and makes the play. Swinging at that first pitch was Anna Gamboa, the freshman, the younger Gamboa. So one pitch, one out. Brings us back to Nicole Green, the center fielder.
Green grounded out to short. And a hard hit shot back in the third.
This one gets underneath the glove of Castro. A base hit into left field for Green.
One out single by Green, her first time aboard.
So here's Kristen Simpson, the second baseman.
Second baseman, Kristen Simpson.
With one on and one out here in this fifth inning. Gilroy up 1-0. Right in there on the inside corner with the breaker.
Mount Pleasant and all that black and red.
Yeah.
Gilroy's got the reflective white and blue. Unexpectedly warm day here in San Jose.
Especially in our little seat with these shiny silver bleachers.
Yeah, not just us. We had a man had to be taken off because of heat.
Here's a grounder foul. We hope that elder gentleman is okay.
Yes, absolutely. There used to be mesh that covered up this entire seating area.
It's now over the dugout of the,
it's now over
the teams.
Dugouts.
Yeah. So 1-2 count. Swinging a grounder to third. Here's Castro with it. She'll go to second. Gets the lead runner. Can't get the double play. That was really close at first. But the lead runner cut down.
So, fielder's choice. I actually think that was the right call.
Mm-hmm.
Now batting right fielder, Tomlinson.
So here's Tomlinson. Junior right fielder. Two down and a runner at first, looking to add to their 1-0 lead. Bit outside, and 1-0 the count.
It's the error committed with two outs in the last inning, which allowed Gilroy to get on the scoreboard.
There's a foul. Count is even at one apiece. Alcantara rubbing that ball on her hip, waiting for her sign, and now has it. Swinging a grounder right back to her. She will calmly make the play to first, and the side is retired. Still 1-0, Gilroy, as we head to the bottom of the fifth.
The Mustangs in the top of the fifth, no runs, one hit. No cardinal errors, one runner left on
Mount base. Pleasant of San Jose. What a different kind of softball season for them. The history of the school here in their first ever CCS championship game. Girls seem to be handling the nerves very well.
I would say so. They look excited and ready. Gilroy team as well. They got to feel like they're playing with house money at this point. The run they've been on.
Well, although they're seated behind Mount Pleasant, I would think there are some people who would regard them as the favorites since they did break. They did defeat the number one seed, the previously unbeaten Mitty Monarchs. But Mount Pleasant, the higher seed and the home team here today.
So Leilani Lane to lead it off.
Leading off the bottom of the fifth for the Cardinals, second baseman Laura
Hatke. That's Laura Hatke is leading off.
I think they've got that Same long black-haired ponytail there.
Swing and a miss.
You know, the one thing there are a number of things I like about Lauren Castro, but one thing I really like is just she picks a different pitch to open with. So just when you think she's going to go outside, she comes inside on you. She really gets you off balance.
0-1 is fouled back, 0-2. She does use the whole repertoire, a lot of variety, mixes it up. Jaquez, the second baseman, down 0-2, leading off this bottom of the fifth. This one a bit up and away. As again, Lauren Castro went back to the outside corner on strike two. This one a high chopper to short. Has to reach up for it. Gets the play.
That was not easy.
No.
Different kind of a side bounce. So great job.
Kehlana Ma with a great play at short. Played that hop well. So now with one out.
Yana is retired on that comebacker to Castro back in the second to end the inning.
This one low and inside. Yanez ahead in the count 2-0. Swing and a foul, straight back.
No walks issued by Castro thus far. She has 7 strikeouts. Seems like even when she falls behind in the count, there's no sort of panic. It almost doesn't seem like any kind of advantage. And happy birthday, the chant. Mona Lisa celebrating a birthday.
Swing and a miss, strike two. See if the birthday girl can't get on base here. The count is even now, though. The pitcher's duel we expected developing here in this fifth. Only one earned run. The difference here, swing and a miss, struck her out. 2 down here in the bottom of the fifth.
Swinging at the high heat goes Yanez. That had some pep on it.
Sure did. So here is Leilani Lane, the left fielder, with 2 down. Looking to try to keep this inning going.
Left fielder, Leilani Lane.
And the pitch, bit high, ball one. Castro winds and delivers. Swinging a grounder past third for a base hit.
Nice. 2-out single.
Nice diving effort by Celeste Mendoza. Couldn't quite come up with that hot shot.
Right fielder, Megan Glaser.
Third base runner for Mount Pleasant comes with 2 outs. In fact, every single base runner for Mount Pleasant in this game has come with 2 outs.
Yeah, that's hasn't allowed any big rallies to happen yet. Lauren Castro seems to settle in every time. Pitches, attempted a bunt, the runner goes, can't handle the throw though, and she is safe.
You love the coaching by Mount Pleasant there.
Yeah, they really needed to get that runner into scoring position, knowing how precious it is.
And I think Lauren Castro, a bit of delay that throw was coming from her catcher.
Much like Alcantara earlier on the throw from third.
Yeah.
The 0-1 delivery, just a bit inside. Nope, he calls the strike. 0-2.
Well, you said that about Castro. When she's got a base runner, it seems she only gets better.
Megan Gracer looking to drive Lane in from second. And strike three called on the outside part of the plate. Again, Lauren Castro gets out of trouble with the runner on. And as we head to the top of the sixth, still 1-0 Gilroy. Kirsten Fairchild with the call the rest of the way through.
Nine strikeouts for Lauren Castro after five complete innings. And as we mentioned, Mount Pleasant getting those runners aboard, but always with two outs. So the unearned run, the difference in this one thus far,
the difference
came back in the fourth as Lauren Castro reached on an error and then was doubled home by Amber Gamboa, her catcher. So the battery accounting for that with the help by the error by the Mount Pleasant third baseman. Top of the order for Gilroy, Kaylana Ma, one of two on the afternoon.
Who has played some fantastic shortstop today, too.
Both of our shortstops showing why they play the position.
Indeed.
Ma. Another base hit for Ma. Two for three on the afternoon. As Mendoza steps in, Mendoza 0 for 2. She will head to Rockland to William Jessup University to play softball next year. And again, coming into this tournament, she was batting over 500. But 0 for 2 on the afternoon. Not only does this Mount Pleasant team want the CCS title, so do their fans.
Big time.
Changeup, laid down for a bunt. That's foul. Ooh. Boy, that looked like it was going to be a beauty.
Just tailed off to the right at the end. Good job by the Cardinal fielders to let that one roll.
And great job by Mendoza. I think that was a bit of a surprise, the bunt attempt.
Yeah, definitely caught the Cardinals a bit off guard.
Didn't show it up front. Willing to play the small ball.
Every run precious in this one. Drops this one down.
Did she touch it?
Ooh.
That was some great restraint. It would have been so easy to pick that up, but then would have been such a hard play. So 0-2 the count, and I don't know if Mendoza realized that.
Yeah, she thought that ball had been touched.
Yeah, she shakes her head. Our umpire right there, however. It looked like he had a clear view. So one on, no outs, top of the sixth. Gilroy at bat with a 1-0 lead, but behind in the count, 0-2. This one, a slow dribbler to short, going for second base. Got it. So Mendoza aboard with the fielder's choice, but removes the runner from scoring position.
Another high-risk choice by Randall there to try to cut down the lead runner at second, but she executes it well. High risk, high reward.
Castro, that deep ball to the warning track in center field for the out opening, and she's swinging away early off the backstop for strike one. After two games that ended in five innings due to the mercy rule, it's fun to settle in here.
Yeah.
For a competitive game, this D2 championship.
See a nail biter.
Yeah.
This pitcher's duel.
Mount Pleasant's fans wanted the call.
Yeah, Alcantara tried to bend that one back in, tried to backdoor that breaker. Just missed.
A little boot scoot boogie.
Yeah,
from Castro.
Indeed.
Keep from being hit. This one. And you see the catcher.
Ball.
So difficult to get the mask off. Get your bearings. Where is the ball?
Yeah, that's a tough one by Carrillo.
Carrillo, I'm sure, disappointed. That one within reach.
Yeah, a chance to put a dangerous hitter away. Gave her a second chance.
The 1-2 delivery. Grabbed by the first baseman, unassisted for the second out.
Great pick by Yanez. Snag that thing and step on the bag. was quite the hard hit ball.
Mendoza in scoring position, however, as Amber Gamboa. Gamboa will head to the University of Mary. Now, this is located in Bismarck, North Dakota.
Mm-hmm.
And, in fact, there's a Mount Pleasant athlete going there as well. One for two with a double. This is a roller towards second, taking the time. And despite giving up a lead-off single, Mount Pleasant heads into the dugout without giving up further damage. No runs on one hit.
No runs, one hit.
No errors, and one left stranded.
I believe that's Leilani Lane that's also headed to the same school as
it is.
As Gamboa.
And I think we were the ones who informed the coaching staff of Mount Pleasant that there was a Gilroy, and Mount Pleasant with a connection with that college. Head coach Manuel Resendez, back in the day during his first stint at Mount Pleasant, had a shortstop who is now the coach at Mount Pleasant. I believe that's Angelina Mechicano, who is the head coach. So she obviously doing a good job recruiting out of her former stomping ground.
Indeed.
Top of the order for Mount Pleasant, it's Castro. Castro one for two with a double. Again, all the hits thus far, three of them for Mount Pleasant coming with two outs. And when the two outs and Castro as a base runner, she seems to get even tougher in the circle.
Yeah, the Cardinals have to get a runner on earlier in these innings so they can small ball their way to the run at least. At least they'll have that option.
Again, we got the nickname lineup. For us, it's JoJo Castro, our PA announcer, announcing Jolene Castro. Strike one.
It's good to know the coaching staff felt comfortable with us to give us some nicknames. As we sat in the dugout waiting for him, he said, as long as you don't beg to get in the lineup, I'll answer anything you want.
Just enjoying the shade in the dugout. Yeah. Is this one? Fouled out of play for strike two. Warren Castro, the sophomore in the circle, second year of varsity. Another punch out. 10 strikeouts for Lauren Castro through six and one-third as Resendez, looking for her first hit of the afternoon, steps in. And again, another 500 hitter who's been coming up empty here today. And the slap hitter makes contact for strike one.
Infield playing shallow. They shade her the other way a bit in the outfield.
Foul. 0-2.
Resendez trying to use that speed she showed in center field to lay one down again on there.
Gets her to chase. 11th strikeout. So many have come. That third strike way out of the zone, but great sell job by Lauren Castro.
Shortstop Emily
Randall. Yep, puts it on the outside part of the plate again with two strikes and gets the Cardinal hitter to chase.
Randall had the first hit of the afternoon for Mount Pleasant. Steps in. 1-2. Low for ball one. Contact. Can she beat it out? I almost think that's too hot to handle.
I would agree.
So we'll give her a hit.
That's a tough play in the hole there.
Just hit right out the second baseman.
Yeah, Simpson tried to backhand it. Couldn't get in front of that. The thing had a lot on it.
So Carrillo, the catcher, steps in, a victim. Two strikeouts, still looking for her first hit. And again, Mount Pleasant with a two-out hit.
Two outs again, yeah. Can't do any small ball to try to advance. Got to do it all by running. Stay bluff there or getting some big hits.
Ball one. The dirt.
That almost hit her on the front leg.
Ball two. Right down the gut. Runner goes, but she's safe. Stolen base by Randall.
Just got under the tag, tried the high tag on the high throw, did Ma. She did a great job of just getting to that thing, and so it didn't go into center. So again, they've had to use the steal to get a runner into scoring position with the two outs.
Second stolen base of the game for Mount Pleasant, as it's a 2-1 count to Carrillo, perhaps the biggest at-bat of this game thus far here in the sixth.
Straight
back. Fell back for 2-2.
We'll see if we get more of the same out of Lauren Castro in this situation. She keeps buckling down with these runners on and two outs.
Two down, runner in scoring position. The 2-2. This is popped up.
Oh.
And again, Gilroy gets out of trouble. Mount Pleasant, no runs, one hit. No errors, one left stranded as Gilroy takes a 1-0 lead into the seventh. Big thanks to the folks here at the Central Coast section, including the Commissioner Nancy Lazenby Blazer, Dwayne Morgan, and just the wide variety. Howard Jensen coming out of retirement to work this event, one of his favorites. What a great career he had at the Central Coast section as a teacher. And all the volunteers helped make this possible. The PA announcer, Andre Palizzi, the grounds crew, doing us a favor when they're watering down the field, giving us a few drops, mercifully.
Little gentle mist drops. To cool us down, yeah.
Our producer is Brad Youngquist. On camera, Megan Coffey. I'm Kirsten Fairchild alongside Tim Fitzgerald. Thank you so much for joining us. Our first game going in regulation, and want to announce the results of a CCS baseball final. Willow Glen in 11 innings over St. Ignatius by a score of 4-3. I believe St. Ignatius once led that game 1-0. So while we've had shortened games, two games only going 5 innings over at Muni at CCS Baseball, they're doing the extra inning tango. And Gilroy, Mount Pleasant will need to shut Gilroy down here and then find a way to tie it up in the seventh as Holly Lamb still looking for her first hit and her third at bat. Steps in, number 5 hitter leading off for Gilroy, and looks at ball one.
Holly has made her presence felt in the outfield for sure. Even carrying that over right now.
Low. I thought that might have been a strike, but just below the zone. Two oh. Ground ball, second baseman charges. There's some speed for Gilroy, but they get her.
By a step.
Yes, Anna Gamboa. She has popped up to third. Tired on a fly ball to left. Still looking for her first hit. One out, top of the seven. Gilroy, the 8th seed. Mount Pleasant, the 7th seed. Gilroy up 1-0 on an unearned run. Strike one.
We have saved our best for last here. We got our pitcher's duel. It's going to come down to this seventh inning.
A little blooper to first. And it's two down. Cole Green, one for two. Had a single back in the fifth after grounding out to short. So two outs for Green. Ground ball to short. Three up, three down for Mount Pleasant. The fate of their season rests entirely on their offense as the pitcher will lead off the seventh, trailing 1-0. Her counterpart today, Lauren Castro, 11 strikeouts. She has given up four hits, one for extra bases. Mount Pleasant's been able to steal two bases, but have not been able to advance a runner past second.
Yeah, Alcantara has pitched beautifully today. It's a shame she's down 1-0 on the unearned run, though she may have sort of helped that error along by being in the area of the throw, but she has pitched a great game. She'll have a chance to make a difference here, leading off this bottom of the seventh.
None of the three hitters have reached base, but Leilani Lane, who would hit fourth, singled back in the fifth, and was able to steal a base as well. So Celine Alcantara.
We go to the bottom of the seventh, leading off for Mount Pleasant. Pitcher Celine Alcantara.
She's carried this team all year. In the circle, can she help her own cause up at bat? Bottom of the seventh, Gilroy dealing with a 1-0 lead. Strike one.
First pitch hacking on a ball away out of the zone.
This game almost seems to beg for extra innings.
It does.
There's been no dominance. There's been no establishment of a better team, if you will. But Lauren Castro has been superb in the circle. No balls, two strikes.
Yeah, I would say the one advantage I would give to Gilroy is only base runners have happened with two outs.
Ground ball to short. Shortstop charging. One away. Two outs away for Gilroy from its first CCS title since 1999, but they're going to have to get through Laura Jaquez.
Although the one unearned run happened with two outs as well in that inning. So it has been about as evenly matched as you could want it to be.
Strike one. High, inside, tight. Jaquez lays off. That's strike one. A base runner on with just one out.
How about that? Jaquez.
Her first hit of the afternoon. Is this the spark Mount Pleasant needed? Mona Lisa Yanez, the first baseman, steps in. A runner aboard with one out. And a conversation. Our head coach, Manuel Resendez, is the first base coach. And we're going to have a courtesy runner. Or actually a pinch runner, not a courtesy runner, for Jaquez. So Mona Lisa Yanez serenaded again with the birthday. So the base runner is number four, Darina Monte.
Number four, Davina Montes.
Davina Montes, base runner.
Now batting first baseman, Mona Lisa Yanez.
So it's your birthday. You're down a run, mm-hmm. one out. Runner on first. If she hasn't blown out candles yet, I think she would like to take her wish right now. Come through and deliver here.
Ooh. That one looked a bit up and away, but they call it a strike.
Remember, this is the bottom of the seventh, so Mount Pleasant needs to tie, and if they can come through, they could end it right here.
It all comes down to this inning.
Away for 1-1. I must say that Gamboa has a great fake throw.
Definitely.
This one lifted high, but it's shallow, and it drops. Back-to-back singles for Jaquez and the birthday girl. Happy birthday, Mona Lisa Yanez. One down, two on, and Leilani Lane, who singled back in the fifth, has the scenario she desired, stepping in here in the bottom of the seventh. Go-ahead run is aboard. The tying run is at second, and the Mount Pleasant fans are glad they made the short trip on over.
Lane trying to add some icing to the Jaquez cake right now, keeping this thing going. Two on, one out.
See, we've witnessed the composure of Lauren Castro all afternoon. 11 strikeouts on the day. Pressure cooker just inched up a little. Strike one.
A little too pumped up for that one. You can see the difference. The Cardinal crowd, pretty loose. The Gilroy crowd, a little nervous about clinging to that one run.
Nevertheless, this has been a fantastic ball game.
Sure has.
A lot of defense. The 0-1 lifted high. Out number two. And it's up to the number nine hitter, Megan Gracer, the right fielder. She has struck out twice, two down, two on.
Now batting, left fielder, Megan Gracer.
Gilroy fans not caring.
Everybody comes to their feet. Straight
foul
back.
Foul tip for strike one. Again, two down, two on. Number nine hitter at bat. Her team trailing by one, bottom of the seventh. It's either going to end right here or extend right here. Up to Megan Gracer. 1-1. Lauren Castro has shown consistently that she will throw strikes. Not sure if laying off here is the best strategy, but Gracer needs to not chase and find something she wants to take for a ride. Gracer, a chopper, and it's over. The unassisted play by the shortstop, Gilroy, wins the Central Coast Section Division III Championship by a score of 1-0. The number 8 seed victorious, the first CCS softball title for the school of Gilroy since 1999.
For the Cardinals, in the seventh inning, no runs, two hits.
What a finish.
Two runners left on base.
Great play by Ma to track that down and head to the bag for that final out. What a dominant performance by Lauren Castro. The Cardinals threatened at the end. Celine Alcantara was just as good, but the unearned error decides it.
11 strikeouts for Lauren Castro. No walks. She gave up six hits. and Gilroy, excuse me, Mount Pleasant leaves six stranded.
Game time, 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Mount Pleasant.
Don't go anywhere. In just a few moments, we'll have our championship.
Ending its season at 22-6 overall, the season ends for Gilroy as well. The 19th win, the Swede had 19 wins to 12 losses. But better than that, a CCS championship. We'll return with our Play on Sports.com post-game show. Gilroy victorious in San Jose, a 1-0 win over the Mount Pleasant Cardinals.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect.
Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream.
Camera 3.
Beautiful.
Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Welcome back to Powell Stadium for the PlayOnSports.com postgame show. The Division II championship in the Central Coast Section softball bracket has been decided for the first time since 1999. Gilroy High wins the second CCS title in the history of girls softball with a 1-0 win over the Mount Pleasant Cardinals of San Jose. Kirsten Fairchild, Tim Fitzgerald. Tim, as far as nail biters go, that was certainly a nail biter for all of the fans here today. And credit Gilroy for finding a victory through the pitcher. I mean, really, it was Lauren Castro who kept Mount Pleasant so off balance.
Sure was. The 11 Ks today, she was dominant, especially when there were two outs. There could be a runner on. She'd buckle down and get out of the jam and worked both sides of the plate up and down, mixed in her pitches. And she was the difference today for sure.
Absolutely. And again, the 11 strikeouts. She did give up 6 hits, no walks, but more importantly, no runs. Mount Pleasant really threatening with the one-out rally in the 7th. You know, sometimes games like this, really pitching duels, it comes down to timing. And it was the timing of Mount Pleasant that just was a little off. And when Castro could make them pay, she certainly did.
Yeah, we got the pitcher's duel we expected. In our pregame, we're like, well, we think this one's going to be about the pitching. Some of these other games are about the offense. And it sure was. It came down to these two pitchers. It's a shame it came down to an unearned run that was executed fairly well, just a little high throw. But that's how it goes. And that was the deciding factor today.
Yes, in a few of the games where there had been so many errors, this one really sticks out because the game was so evenly played on both sides and so well played.
Indeed. Yeah, it's really got the nail biter. These crowds were very into it, and it was an exciting finale to this triple header.
Absolutely. And congratulations to Notre Dame Salinas.
It happened.
On behalf of the producer, Brad Youngquist, Megan Coffey on camera, and my partner today, Tim Fitzgerald, I'm Kirsten Fairchild. Big thanks to everyone here at Powell Stadium and, of course, the folks at the Central Coast Section. And thank you for joining us. Mount Pleasant earning its first trip to CCS, but they come up short. They'll settle for the runner-up as Gilroy claims its second title with a 1-0 victory. Thank you for joining us on PlayOnSports.com, your destination for high school sports. So long from San Jose.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.